Hello students, today we will discuss about the Raman spectroscopy. Here the Raman spectroscopy is a study of the scattering of light. You might have heard about Sir C.V. Raman. In 1928, he has observed that when a substance of any state or a molecule of any state is irradiated with the monochromatic light of a definite frequency, then the light is scattered, which is right angles to that of the incident radiation. And if the frequency of the scattered light may be lower or higher than that of the incident light, or frequency of the scattered light may be that is equal to the frequency of the incident light, and thus this discrete frequencies that is above and below that of the frequency of the incident light will be scattered, that is called as a Raman scattering. So, here we are going to study the scattering of light, that is right angles to that of the frequency of the incident light. So, here if the frequency of the scattered light is lower than that of the frequency of the incident light, then it is called as the Stokes lines. If the frequency of the scattered light is higher than that of the incident light, then it is called as anti-Stokes line. Suppose if you get the lines with a similar frequency, that means the frequency of the scattered light which is similar to that of the frequency of the incident light, then that lines are called as a Rayleigh line. Here in this picture, we can see the Stokes lines, anti-Stokes line and the Rayleigh line. Here, nu I is the intensity of the frequency of the incident light, and nu s is the frequency or intensity of the scattered light. Suppose the Vs is equal to Vi, that means nu s is equal to nu I, that means the frequency of the scattered light is equal to the frequency of the incident light, then there is a formation of a Rayleigh line. And if the nu s is greater than nu I, that means the frequency of the scattered light which is greater than that of the incident light, then the anti-Stokes line, that lines are called as a anti-Stokes line. Suppose if we get intensity of the incident light is greater than that of the scattered light, then we'll get the Stokes lines. So there is a three types: Stokes line, anti-Stokes line, and also the Rayleigh line. And here with the C.V. Raman, he also observed that the difference in the frequencies of the scattered light and the incident light that are constant, and it is depends upon the nature of the substance, and it is independent of the frequency of the incident light. Suppose if we consider the electromagnetic radiation which is having a frequency nu, then nu naught is the frequency of the incident light and the nu s is the frequency of the scattered light, then delta nu, that is given by nu naught minus nu r, that is the difference between the two frequencies, frequency of the incident light and the frequency of the scattered light. And this difference between the two frequencies, which are called as, which is called as a Raman shift, and this Raman shift which is represented by a wave numbers, so delta nu, that is given by 1 by lambda I minus 1 by lambda s, where I represents the incident light and S represents the scattered light. So this is the Raman shift. And the Raman frequencies for any particular substances which are the characteristic of that substances, and these observation which are made by a Raman, so that it is called as a Raman effect, and the spectrum which is obtained here, that is called as a Raman spectrum. And here the Raman spectroscopy, which can be used to determine the vibration in or a vibrational modes of the substances, and also rotational modes and some of the low frequency modes of the molecule. Next, let us discuss the instrumentation here. As we know that in the Raman spectroscopy, we are going to study the scattering of light. So, using a Raman spectrometer, we can study the scattered light, that is right angles to that of the incident light. Here, the Raman spectrometer, which consists of a light source, sample tube, monochromator, and detector. Here, this is the skeletal representation of the Raman spectrometer. Here, this is the sample source and it is the sample tube. And here, there are a slit and lens, which is the, this is the prism and the photographic plate where we can record the spectrum. So, next we'll discuss one by one. The first one is the Raman source. Here, since the frequency of the scattered light is very, very less, that is about 0.01% of the incident radiation. So, an extremely intense source of radiation can be used here. For example, mercury arc lamp and the lasers which are used as a Raman source. Suppose the lasers which are used as a source or a sample source, then the filtering is not necessary because the energy output which is in the form of monochromatic light. The next one is the sample. Here the liquid sample which can be used, and the sample or a liquid sample which can be taken in a sample tube, that sample tube which is provided with the optical window at the other end. And gaseous samples are also measured by using a Raman spectrometer. Suppose the mercury arc lamp which is used as a source, then the radiation which is passes through a cylindrical walls of the sample tube, and then the light is scattered, and scattered light which is escape out of the optical window present at the other end of the sample tube. This is about the samples. And next one, filter and monochromators. Here monochromator or filters which are used to remove the high wavelength radiation. So if you use the higher wavelength radiation, then it removes or it dissociates the molecule. So that in order to avoid this, the filters or a monochromators which were used here. The last, that is the detectors. The Raman spectrum that can be photographed with an ordinary spectrograph, and actually there are two ways to detect and record the spectrum, but easiest way is to gather all the scattered radiation which is escaping from the optical window at the other end of the sample tube. Then that scattered light is passed through the prism, and then it is passed through the photographic plate where the spectrum can be recorded. And this is about the instrumentation of a Raman spectrometer. And here I have explained when the mercury arc lamp is used as a source. Then suppose the lasers which are used as a source, then filtration or a filtering or a monochromator which were not used. And also suppose the lasers which produces the radiation, that lasers which concentrate only on the capillary which contains the sample. Thank you.